I'm playing the Indian Santoor. This instrument has about 31 different notes that we can play. Typically the way that we tune the instrument is that we tune it so that it has all the notes of the rag that we're going to play. What is a rag? A rag is a selection of notes. But it's not just a selection of notes. We, of course, are limited to the notes of that rag, those selected notes, but also there are certain rules in Indian classical music, Hindustani classical music, and those notes, there are certain ways that those notes can be played. Certain notes might have a rule that says that you can only play the third note after touching the fourth note, or you can only play a certain note on the ascent when you're going up through the scale, or you may only touch certain notes on the way down. And so those are the rules, are some of the rules that make up the theory behind each rag. So typically we tune the instrument so that it is tuned to the notes of the rag that we are playing. The rag that I have tuned my instrument right now is rag Vachaspati. This is a rag that was borrowed into Hindustani music from Carnatic music. I'll just quickly just play up and down the scale so that you can get a sense for what the notes are on this particular rag. So that's just a really brief introduction to the rag that my instrument is tuned to. But getting down, taking a step further back to introduce the instrument to you, the Santoor has about 31 different notes, and each note is actually, you get the sound by striking each of these bridges. So each bridge, what in dulcimer language is called a course. So I have, speaking in those terms, I have 31 courses here. And on each course, I have three strings that are tuned to a given particular note. And they have to be tuned, of course, exactly. So each string has to be tuned exactly to the note that you're trying to strike so that you get a perfect note on it, perfect pitch on it. And what we do is, like the hammer dulcimer, we get the sound by striking with these two wooden strikers. There are two, of course, and we strike them in different ways to get different effects from the instrument. Before I get into how we use the strikers, there are different ways in which in the Santoor playing styles, there are different ways in which different performers hold in the strikers. Some performers actually hold it in this way, sort of like this. Then there are a lot of other performers who will actually hold the strikers using the second and third fingers and using the thumb sort of to control the movement of the strikers. And that this latter style is the one that I play with. It's the style that my guru taught me. And so that's the style I use, and you'll see me playing. The different types of movements that we use with the Santoor in conjunction with Hindustani music is, for example, we in the first movement that we do, we introduce the rag. And to introduce the rag, one of the most distinctive features of Hindustani music is what is known as the alap. And in the alap stage, we're introducing note by note the beauty of the rag. And to do that, we improvise on the santoor by gliding the striker across the various courses, slowly introducing step by step each note and bringing out the beauty of the rag. I'll just demonstrate for a few seconds something so you get at least a flavor for it. That's a very short part of the alap, and you could see that what I was doing was moving between notes by gliding the striker across the various courses, and slowly, step by step, note by note, introducing the rag. So that's one of the types of movements that we use on the santoor with the strikers. The second stage after the alap is completed, we will introduce rhythm into what we're playing. And we use the left hand and the right hand strikers to produce produce sound, but also keeping rhythm as we play. Just a quick small piece just to demonstrate that. Was keeping sort of helping keep the beat. Right hand was actually playing the main theme of what I was, the musical idea that I was trying to communicate with the listener. Hindustani music we call it the jod jhala. That's the stage of the presentation of the rag. A couple of other things that we do is we also use the strikers and produce a movement known as the dhira dhira. The dhira dhira is where we use the left hand, right hand to actually play the same note, and it's used at typically the towards the end of the raga, and it's typically one of the faster paces that we use. The tempo is actually pretty fast at that stage. But just to demonstrate, I'm not going to go up at the full speed. I'll try and demonstrate the movement that we do for the dhira dhira. rhythms, which is another type of movement that we use. But the for most part, when we play the instrument, this is the way that we play the notes is that the right hand dominates over the left hand, and that's very unique about the style developed by my teacher. And so the right hand, you'll see, does most of the movements. The left hand is in a supporting role. For example, when I was playing the jhala as well, the left hand was keeping the beat, right hand was actually playing all the notes, the primary notes of the musical idea that the artist is trying to convey. And for all the other pieces, the movements that take place too, you'll notice a similar thing. The only exception where the right hand and left hand are played one-to-one almost is in the dhira dhira mode, which is this one. Now, there are some other techniques that we do. For example, there's a unique technique that my teacher uses, which is known with called damping. And what they do is that the left hand goes down, the striker. He doesn't use the left hand striker for that. And he'll play this, which requires, and I'm not very good at this. I'll try and demonstrate as best as I can, so bear with me. Effect. So your left hand is actually damping the sound produced, and the right hand striker is the only one that's striking the strings. And I guess the last technique that I have seen with this is where the left hand is used to actually just pluck the strings, just sort of pluck the strings, pretty much like you would do with a plectrum, but you're using the fingernails to do it, and the right hand is actually providing, filling in the notes there. So let me try and demonstrate. Again, this is not something that I use too often, but I'll do whatever I can to actually demonstrate. Techniques that I wanted to talk about. Other than that, I think you see some artists who will actually put pressure on one of the strings here to sort of produce a wave modulation of the sound, but that's not one of the things that in the style of Santoor playing that my teacher has taught me to do, so we don't really use that. I think the styles that I have covered, or the techniques that I've covered, are probably the most important ones that we use when we play the Santoor. Thank you.